everybody for coming. So this is our first guest event here at the Arches, and it's a collective called Tracksound, and this is the first of how many? Four events, Charlotte?
Four events.
The next one's in Birmingham, so you've got this is the first one, yeah. And it's the local one. So the actual film is it's exactly 42 minutes long. And then afterwards there'll be some time for questions and answers if you wish. Beforehand, I'm just going to hand you over to Michele Catania. How's that? He's composed the music for the screening, and he's just going to share a little introductory piece before we begin.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
you guys for being here with us. It's really great to have you here. So what you've just heard were all original compositions from Michele Catania from Sicily. They've been used for various purposes, TV adverts, spots, documentaries, for movies as well. And so now for today's event, we're gonna showcase another composition of Michele for a very specific project, the one Momi's Dream, La Guerra del Sogno di Momi, originally. So just a few details to introduce you to the piece that you're about to see. It's a silent movie that has been commissioned by the Tala film production to Segundo de Chomon, who's the original director and producer of the movie, back in 1917. So it's already a movie which has some history. We're talking here about the first animated movie in Italy. So Segundo de Chomon was a French director, very famous for his expertise in regards of our special effects. Originally it was a silent movie, but then 4 years ago, the National Museum of Turin restored the movie. The images that you will see are original though. And yeah, Michele basically took the opportunity to compose the live soundtrack to the movie with a four-piece chamber orchestra. About the movie itself, so you will see it's about the life of Momi, who's a child, and who's sitting with his family. They get a letter from his father, who's at the front. So he's a soldier fighting for the war, and as the father tells about his adventures on the battlefield, Momi afterwards falls asleep and he dreams of his own soldiers, wooden soldiers that undertake a horrible war. So it's very interesting to see the film and to have the actual music accompaniment next to it, because you should see how the music basically illustrates the movie and helps to its comprehension. So for this purpose, we've got our four musicians that are going to join us now. So we've got Arjun at the clarinet, Kaethe on the flute.
Thank you. Thank you. Arjun Jethwa on the flute. Kaethe Uken on the clarinet. On the cello. Ginevra Paniati, conduction and cello. And we have to, if you have some question about the movie, there are some. A lot of strange stuff in this movie. Yes, I know. But the interesting thing of this movie is that the movie follows the psychology of the child during his sleeping. And for this reason, for example, I decided to compose in the second part some part without music, with the void. Because when we dream, sometimes our dreams are not regular, but there is some void. For this reason, I decided to put some silence. But it's very interesting that the movie itself. There are, for example, the two scenes with the improvisation, with a lot of noise. I decided to compose, to let improvise the musician, because there are the two new weapons in the First World War. There was the gas and the flights. It was the first time in the history that there was this kind of weapons, this new stuff. And I thought to the futurism, the movement of the futurism, in the early 20s of the 9th century, and for this reason, I think that the movie is very amazing for the visual effects. The step motion is one of the first trial about this kind of techniques, and It's enough. If you have some questions, we are here. Or if you are satisfied, thank you for coming. Thank you to Charlotte Pietschmann for the organization and for everyone. Thank you to James that helped us a lot. And Josh today was very, very kind. Thank you.
Screening now as part of the Tracksound project. So Tracksound is just few words really. We would like to re-establish the role of music as a complete element as part of the thought that nowadays there's basically a current soundtrack in our lives. There's music on the radio, in the shops, everywhere. We always hear some noise, so we just wanted to put back the importance of music also as an illustrative element, but also as a full art piece. Yeah. So I don't know if you're all online, but we're also on Facebook. You can follow us, find some details on the Fermynwood website as well. So we're on social media, and we're planning on developing the events in Birmingham, in Manchester,
Thank you very much.
Michele, was this originally shown with a piano?
I don't know. I composed directly. Yes, no, I composed directly for the chamber group. Yes, and for this reason, I composed directly with these instruments. And the idea to compose for a chamber group is because I imagined to be inside the mind, inside the feelings of the child, and he was inside his own salon, his own room. For this reason, I wanted to recreate the similar environment of a house. For this reason, and just some 2-3 years ago, someone suggested me to create an orchestral version, but I don't think it's a good idea because chamber sound is the right sound for this kind of movie. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I think, obviously, is my opinion.
And how did you find the film?
Yes, there was my friend that is a movie critic, and in this moment he directed for 2 years the restoring center in Mexico City. He worked at the National Museum of Cinema. Someone 5 years ago asked me something to compose for a silent movie. When I found this movie, I thought that I considered this work not commission work. It's similar to my own work because I felt very close with the thematic of the movie, the childhood, the war. We are living very strange times. In this moment, I think it's a good idea to present this movie because it's not very famous, obviously. It's a silent movie of 1917, but this movie moved inside me something not only, there is some strange stuff to create with music, but I feel the feelings inside the movie are very close to my name when I found this movie. Was perfect. For this reason, every time that we project the movie, we need to ask the permission to the National Museum of Cinema, because they restored, obviously. There is my own. Yes, when I found it, it was amazing. I decided that I wanted to explain to you that the idea behind this work when I saw the first time the movie, there was only improvised music from the beginning to the end without sense. It was very hard to follow the movie with that kind of music because in this moment there is a lot of sonorization around only contemporary music, but not very linked with the movie. This is a problem for us musicians. And I tried to use different techniques, composition techniques, because in this moment, I don't know, the normal soundtracks on the movie are always the same, until 10 or 15 years ago, when we watch a movie, we recognize immediately that that music for all was only for that specific movie. Mm. Now every music is the same. If you, I don't know, if you watch some blockbuster movie, or is set in ancient Greek, or is in the Middle Age, every time there is the same sound. For example, my models, Ennio Morricone, Nino Rota, John Williams, for them, every single work, every single movie was a reason to study, to find, to look for the right sound, the right language for that movie. In this moment, music is like only a complement, it's not part. And we are, yes, as Charlotte told before, we have music everywhere, always, in the phones, everything. And music is losing importance, maybe. I think I'm scared about it, of it, but it will happen. It is happening now. Yes, I think. Okay. I don't know if I only my suggestion, but I don't think the music is very clear that in the moment every music is similar. Netflix, for example, you can put a music from a movie and put in another is the same, and the directors too are not. I noted, for example, in my experience. When I started to compose for movies 6-7 years ago, there was more. They wanted to go deep. Sorry for my English. Sometimes I'm just improving my English. But then at the beginning, okay, we have to find together with the conduct with the director the right music. In the last years, for this reason, I gave up a little bit music for movies because okay, funny music, this rhythm. I would like to fight with the conductor, with the director to find the right way to explain the stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a different process.
Yes, it's a different process. Maybe it's a little bit old stuff.